In this video, I'm going to talk about profile of a line. So profile of a line is a two-dimensional tolerance in that it controls one section at a time and not an entire surface. In some cases, it's very similar to a tolerance, a form tolerance like straightness. In other cases, it can be very similar to circularity. It depends how it's applied. Let me give you an example. We have a simple block with a hole in it. Plus or minus locating this surface, we've got profile of a line, tolerance value, no datum reference. Right? I've indicated a datum feature symbol here. We'll use it in a minute. This is a possible part. Our tolerance zone, this is directional, right? Because it's sections at a time. We're slicing the part like this. So the best way to think of it is this line needs to be straight. So we're checking here, but we're not checking here, which would be going in and out of the part, okay? Only checking one direction. So here's our 10,000th tolerance zone. And over here, right, there's no geometric control besides rule number one, right? So a full 40,000ths. With no datum reference, right, we're not measuring it to anything, it's unconstrained. We're just looking for straight lines. We could end up with something like this, as long as it's within the limits of size. Okay? So in this case, I'd argue it's basically the same thing as a straightness tolerance. Straightness applied to a surface, or applied to a surface. The tolerance zone is two parallel lines. Now, what makes it different from straightness is we can use datum references. So if we reference datum A, right, the opposite surface, now we're going to be controlling the parallelism of each line segment, right? But just the parallelism. Recall, parallelism or orientation never controls location. So what's going to happen is, right, this is not going to be allowed. We've got to be within this tolerance zone has to be parallel to this bottom surface. Right, back to where we started. But because it's parallel, we're checking kind of each 10,000ths two parallel lines at different spots in the other direction, right? Going this way, right, and again, this way is in and out of the board. Now I've tried to show a hole here so you can get this is third angle projection. Okay, that can be handy in some situations, I suppose. Can't really think of any off the top of my head, but it's available. Now, where this can kind of break down, if we made this basic, it's the same thing as profile of a surface. Because there's no variation here, we're checking individual line elements, but they're all exactly 1 inch from our datum simulator. Right? So this is not allowed, right? We're 1 inch away, right? We're checking every spot. We would have to, essentially, it becomes a profile of a surface. Now, I'm just showing you this just in case you ever see it, right? This is kind of a no-no. Now, we can use profile of a surface with profile of a line, which I think is the common way to do it, right? Let's go profile of a surface, 4,000ths to A, keep profile of a line, 10,000ths to A. Before, we had 1 plus or minus 20. We're essentially just replacing that with profile of a surface of 40, so 20 on either side of the true profile. In that case, this profile of a line is controlling this one direction, but we've got the profile of a surface that controls everything, but you know, where it makes a difference is this direction. So over here, I'm trying to indicate these are basic dimensions, right? Locating our true profile. We've got 10,000ths for a profile of a line in one direction only, but but 40 thousandths in the other direction. Now you also have 40 thousandths in this direction, but it doesn't really matter because this is gonna kind of limit it. So you need to control the location with either the plus or minus, which is the figure shown in Y14 2009. If I can recall right, that's literally the only figure that has profile of a line in it. It's a situation where you're locating a surface with a plus or minus dimension. In Y14-5-2018, there's two figures. There's one similar to the 2009, and there's another one that shows a customized datum reference frame, which maybe I'll show that for save that for another video. If you're interested, leave a comment down below and I can explain that whole figure. So when do you use profile of a line? Let me give you one example. So here's an example of what I would call like a weather stripping. Imagine you have something that's got a constant section shape, but it's very long. So a weather stripping, extrusion, something like that. Now this section, or the cross section, is going to be dimensioned with basic dimensions. I've shown two, but there would be more. So we're saying all basic dimensions. That's going to define our true profile. We're going to do profile all around. We're saying profile of a surface which controls not only the cross section, but the entire length of the part as well. So what we're saying here is if you stretch this out to its full length, 48 inches, it needs to be straight within a half of an inch. So if it's, you know, somewhat flexible, maybe that's exactly what you want. I know it sounds like an absurdly large tolerance, but you know, even if it's aluminum over 4 feet, it might be a little bit bent, but maybe it could be used just fine in service. Pretty easy check to make. You would put it on a table and, you know, just check it with a feeler gauge or something. Here, right, we want to keep the cross section closer because if it is weather stripping, it's got to like fit into something. So each cross section has 10 thousandths. But that 10 thousandths does not apply for the full length. That might be more difficult to control. Now, there's no datum references here, right? That does make it a little tricky to measure, but keep in mind, right, this could be a good or a bad thing. You've got this tolerance zone of 10 thousandths, goes all the way around the part. So what you might do is, you know, if you're making a lot of this, is cut a slice out and put it on a vision system or an optical comparator, and you can just look and see if what you have is within that tolerance zone. That may be easier than using plus or minus dimensions and then having to go in and try to measure it with a caliper and figure out what all the tolerance zones are on that. I'm not saying this is perfect in every situation, but this is how it could work, and this is a use case of profile of a line. So that's it for this video. If you want to know more about profile of a line, leave a comment down below and I'll get to it when I can. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below.